Ever since there's been a Linux operating system, there has been Linux gaming. Now, early on, that was going to be native games, but here's a fun fact. The Wine Project started in 1993, 2 years after the Linux kernel. Now, early on, there wasn't exactly much of a market, Wine wasn't very good yet, and you were basically just going to be playing games made specifically for Linux. Now, come 2013, things changed just a little bit. The launch of Steam for Linux with over 50 titles. It's better than nothing, but it's still a relatively small selection. So I don't know why Valve did this, but in 2015, we saw the Steam machines, and whilst the roster was a little bit bigger, it was still very tiny, and the Steam machines didn't go exactly well, we'll say, but we did get a very cool controller from it. It wasn't until a bit later in 2018, with the launch of Proton, that things really began to change. By this point, a lot more games had native Linux support, but native support didn't really matter anymore, because now Valve was putting their force behind Wine, behind Proton, and trying to make it so you could just play Windows games under Linux. And the list they had at this point was very, very short, but even at this point, there were other games that Valve had not tested yet that were completely playable, let alone what happened a year later, 2 years later, 3 years later. Eventually, we had the release of the Steam Deck, and things are in a really good state today. But all of that is history. Let's look towards the future. There is a website called SteamDB. This tracks basically everything going on Steam, both publicly and unlisted, including player counts, pricing changes, file changes, basically everything you want to know. Now, because of that unlisted part, it tends to be a hotbed of leaks from both Valve and other developers who kind of forget that things are listed here. Here we have Valve Test App 3043620, a very unassuming name for a project that hasn't yet been publicly announced by Valve, but very clearly shows that something is going on here. This contains a very interesting list of compatibility tools, the first one being WeDroid. WeDroid, a container-based approach to boot a full Android system on regular GNU/Linux systems running Wayland-based desktop environments. It's technically not an Android emulator, but it serves the same function. And currently, there are two versions available in this list, the regular stable release and the dev release. Now, I do not understand the images being used for these, because as you can tell from this, this is how WeDroid markets itself. I don't know who made this image. I don't know where this image came from. I don't know why it exists, but I kinda like it. And there's also this version. Again, if you can provide me context, please, please do here. The only thing I can think of is somehow Joshua Ashton has something to do with this. But that is not the only tool. Proton ARM64EC. We know exactly what Proton is. This is for playing Windows games under Linux. ARM64, this implies a 64-bit ARM version of Proton. The EC part isn't entirely clear, but maybe that's what it's supposed to mean. Along with there being a few versions here, -5, -4, -experimental, -vanguard, and another one that's very weird to me, -Wukong. Now, I don't know the deal with the -Wukong and the -Vanguard names, because neither of them are used on Wukong or Vanguard games. So I have a feeling these are just like internal names that somebody's having fun with, that I don't know, maybe they want to see someone write some dumb article about talking about how there's going to be a Proton version that makes Vanguard work. And lastly, we have FEX. This is a fast user mode x86 and x86-64 emulator for ARM64 Linux. So basically it takes the regular code you run on your Intel and AMD CPU, the x86-64 code, and then makes it run on an ARM64 system. Much like how Wine takes the Windows calls and then makes them run on a Linux system. Along with this, we have a collection of what is being called app mappings, which seem to indicate maybe some sort of testing being done, or maybe auto detection of the correct tool to use with various different games and applications. This includes completely regular titles like Stardew Valley, like Stray, Streets of Rage 4, Kerbal Space Program, Gang Beats, which is one of the ones that has Dash Vanguard. Again, I am almost certain this is trying to bait people into writing a really dumb article. There is no other reason. You call it Vanguard. Windows VR games like Gorilla Tag, along with what I can only assume are Android releases because they're making use of WageDroid, of various Android VR titles like OpenBrush, Moss 2, and Pistol Whip, which for some reason has a frog in its title, which isn't actually there. Like if you search the game up, there will not be a frog in the title. Someone just decided to put a frog there. Now, what I found interesting is nothing is using FEX directly. What I think it's being used for and would logically make the most sense to me is it's being used as part of the Proton ARM 64 EC collection, because Proton by itself doesn't do ARM. It takes Windows to Linux. That is all. It doesn't change the architecture. If you then make use of FEX to convert those x86-64 calls into ARM 64 calls, then you have an architecture that makes a lot of sense. This would not be the first project that's tried to do this. It's not a new invention. It's all open source tech, but it's in a much better state than even where it was a couple of years ago. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. Oh, who sells powerful ARM 64 devices? Apple. Is this something to do with maybe getting Windows games running on Apple devices? I know Apple has their own system, but maybe something directly from Valve themselves. What this says in here is from OS Windows to OS Linux. I have not seen a single mention of Apple anywhere in this data. So that's an interesting theory, but it doesn't line up with anything we can see here. As it currently stands, this is all we have. Valve has not yet made any public announcement about what this is, what they're doing, whether this is even something that is being pursued, or if it's just like one individual developer messing around with things. You know, maybe they're proposing something and like, hey, this is a good idea, let's go and do this. So it's not very clear what's actually going on here. Anyone who's telling you this is for certain what is being done is lying to you. Everything right now is pure speculation. With that being said, based on this data and data from previous leaks, we can make some educated guesses about what might be going on. Now, considering we have both VR and non-VR games, there's a couple of possibilities that make sense to me. Now, considering it's been out for a couple of years at this point and people are talking about maybe a refresh makes sense, of course people mention an ARM-based Steam Deck. Now, there haven't been any prior rumors regarding a device like this or even just a refresh to the Steam Deck whatsoever. Maybe it could be something like a possible cheaper entry point, but I feel like this is probably the least credible of the speculation. But you know what? Valve does random things sometimes. It is entirely possible that is what happens. But there are also those VR games. So there are the long ongoing rumors of the Valve Deckard, which, at least going by prior leaks, which again, nothing has been announced, so leaks will be leaks. It's supposedly going to be a standalone VR headset running Linux, powered by ARM. These are rumors upwards of 3 years in the making at this point. It's possible the tech stack just wasn't there to make it happen earlier, and now that it is, maybe that is actually going to be a real device? Possibly, and it wouldn't surprise me if Valve decided to take the Proton approach with doing VR as well. Rather than trying to have everyone port things over to their system, just make things from the other system work for them. But you know what? It could just be like the Proton approach, where they just don't do anything with it for a couple of years. They just put it out there and it's like, hey, oh, mic fell over. Was like, hey, you can use this. You can play your Android games. You can play things on ARM systems, but we're just going to let it mature. We're going to improve upon it. And one day we'll maybe do something with it. But you know what? I don't think that's exactly a bad situation, because when you have Valve behind Wine, Wine got much, much better really quickly. The same thing can happen to FEX and Wadroid as well. If you put the force of Valve behind something, you put that development effort, it is going to improve. But what do you think? Do you think anything is going to come out of this? Do you think it's just some internal devs messing around with some stuff? Or do you think this is an unannounced project that Valve is going to like hook into a new hardware device they have coming? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out my Patreon, subscribe to Libero Pay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I get really bad VR sickness.